Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for coming back. We're going to talk about estrogen in the body. So estrogen has been very malaligned, you know, for many years, and many people see it as a bad hormone. But when you've got a healthy, functioning, normally balanced body, estrogen is a perfectly fine hormone. But the problem with many people today is we've got so many larger people there, and obesity is becoming quite the norm in many countries. So high saturated animal fat intake in particular is really bad when it comes to estrogen, because this kind of fat intake will really influence certain types of intestinal bacteria to produce an enzyme called beta glucuronidase. Now, beta glucuronidase is something then that can make estrogen a lot more available to transfer through the bloodstream and get into the body and create damage, because estrogen is a proliferative hormone. It makes things grow. It's been linked with many different types of cancers when it's in excess. So you don't want a whole lot of beta glucuronidase activity going on in the body. So, and this is why vegans, vegetarians, or people very cautious with their diets tend to have a different body shape and also a more streamlined, more balanced estrogen progesterone profile than women who tend to eat whatever they want and who have a very high saturated fat intake. So that's the problem. When you've got a lot of saturated fat in your diet and you get a lot of this beta glucuronidase happening, you've got far too much estrogen going on there, and that's not really what you want. So by changing your fat intake, the types of fats that you eat, having really lean protein and having more fish protein, which is an anti-inflammatory fat, because if you look at, for example, beef particular, it tends to be prone to inflammation in the body through a particular pathway. So arachidonic acid. So we don't really want to have too much inflammation going on. So I've got my trusty book here. I'm going to talk about a few points today on how you can really balance estrogen and get a lot better effect, you know, there, and reduce its ability to build up in the body. So we've spoken about obesity. Xenoestrogens, you may have heard of that word xeno, or, you know, foreign estrogens. These are coming through the diet, also through the plastics. So there's been now a global sort of awareness on plastic, but be careful of things like saran wrap or cling wrap, you know, that go on top of food. It's good not to use those, especially on high fat foods where these sort of, like, you know, artificial estrogens can get sucked into that fat. So try and stop using those things. And if you've got food, you know, you want to store, put it in containers with a lid, but don't, you know, put any saran wrap or that plastic wrap on them. Dietary fiber has been known to reduce estrogen, and it's been shown that both through blood, you know, stool and urine studies, that, you know, you can really make a change there with estrogen just by increasing fiber into the diet. Have a look at some of the videos I've completed on fiber. I've completed many videos on that on this channel, the different types of foods you can eat. And also, you may have seen a previous video where I showed you this list here of these foods. I'll just hold it there for a second so you can take a screenshot. So those foods there are some of the best ones when it comes to really increasing the probiotic content of the gut, because they're prebiotic foods. Now, probiotics, particularly lactobacillus acidophilus, has been linked with a lowering of the activity of beta-glucuronidase and also a lowering generally of estrogen in the body. So it's good to eat a little bit of yogurt in your diet and to take a supplement containing lactobacillus acidophilus. There are many papers I've looked at that showed the link between a positive reduction in estrogen by way of the lactobacillus. So a little bit of yogurt in the morning or maybe in the evening is quite a good thing for you to do. Phytoestrogens, plant-based estrogens. So you've got certain plants you can have, you know, like soy, for example, which again has been kicked in the guts and malaligned for years, you know, and I've heard all of these stories about men will grow breasts and develop retardation, even turn into homosexuals when they drink soy milk and all this sort of junk. Now, I'm sure that it won't be long before gluten has been malaligned, and they'll put it in the frankenfoods category, that you're going to, you know, grow horns when you eat bread and stuff like that. There's some crazy people out there. Don't fall for the hype. I still believe that a non-GMO soy product is fantastic food for females, especially those going through the perimenopause and the menopause, because it supplies a plant-based estrogen. Phytoestrogens have also shown to lower the activity of beta-glucuronidase. And they also work on stopping excess estrogen in the body, you know, jamming up receptor sites, because phytoestrogens will dock these receptor sites and act like a kind of estrogen. And so they'll stop the excess burden from occurring. So that's a good one. The other one is the cabbage family. So, you know, brassicas, broccoli, cauliflower, these sorts of things, they contain a substance called indoles, which have a fantastic effect also on lowering this excess estrogen. So indoles competitively inhibit estrogen and seem to inhibit the growth of breast cancer cells. So particularly Brussels sprouts, one of my favorites. You can get supplements which contain indole 3 carbinol, I3C, for example. Many studies again link I3C regular consumption with the reduction of estrogen, excess estrogen in the body. You may also want to get testing done to see what your estrogen is at. And a really good test you can ask your doctor to get done, let me write it down for you. Now, just because I'm Dutch, it doesn't mean to say that I like the Dutch test. Right? Dried urine test for comprehensive hormones. I'll say that again. Dried urine test, comprehensive hormones. That's a fantastic test that will give you a good idea on the hormone levels in your body. The three types of estrogen, because there are three types. Also progesterone, testosterone, melatonin, cortisol, cortisone, all the stress hormones. In fact, the whole hormonal pathway will be revealed through that test. It's a very good test. It's worth doing. Ask your functional medicine doctor or naturopath to get that test done for you, you know, to arrange that one so you can do that one. That'll give you a pretty good idea on your estrogen levels in the body and what you can do about it. Because you don't want estrogen to get out of hand and cause a lot of problems. Because it has been linked with many different types of illnesses in excess. But the key message is get your weight down. Eat the right foods. Eat plenty of fiber in your diet. Eat lean protein. Keep away from deep fried foods. Too much alcohol. And you're going to be in a way better shape. Thanks for tuning in.